federal charges against a fugitive banker who may be hiding out now south of the border. 46-year-old Aubrey Price is missing after allegedly stealing $21 million from the Montgomery Bank and Trust. Could be more than that. A bank that he was running before he allegedly took the money. After he disappeared in June, Price wrote letters to his relatives saying he was despondent and wanted to end his life, even spelling out how he was going to do it, jumping aboard a ferry and jumping off in the middle of nowhere. But the FBI thinks that Mr. Price is very much alive and well, and maybe hiding out in Venezuela or Guatemala. My next guest, Bill Daly, is a former FBI investigator and senior vice president of Control Risks Security Consultant. Bill, welcome back. So, old Aubrey confessed to running a type of Ponzi scheme like Bernie Madoff, where he takes money in, he says he's going to invest it, but in fact he just uses your proceeds to pay somebody else off until the whole scheme collapses. And that's apparently the position in which he found himself.
Apparently position. And much like Madoff, people were calling and looking for the money. They wanted to transfer money out and put it into other investments. And lo and behold, he's not available. They can't get in touch with him. Where's the money? And that house of cards does start to collapse. It's at that point in which we start to see some other movements. He actually moves his family, which had been in the planning stage for several months, from Florida down to Georgia. So it's around where his wife's parents live. Mm-hmm. And then he goes off on a business trip to allegedly Guatemala. He's going to take a ferry trip from Key West, not too sure I got from Guatemala to Key West.
He writes a letter to his family after he's gone saying, I'm going to take a ferry trip from Key West to Fort Myers, board a ferry headed to Fort Myers, Florida, and I plan to jump off somewhere along the way and end my life.
Right. And so not only do we have this letter, this gives me a little bit of suspicion. This is why I've been kind of jaundiced.
It's a little detail.
Maybe a little bit too old in this business to really take things for what they're really, the face value of it. So he writes this letter. Of course, he's admitting to things. Then he starts to say, I'm going to kill myself. Then he goes through the trouble of going to a ferry, buying a ticket, buying dive weights, and all of a sudden apparently disappearing. To me, there's a little bit too much more to the story. Like, where is the rest of the money? It's not just this.
Not just where's the money. Where's the body?
Where's the body? Well, that's it. It could be anywhere you might think from Key West to Fort Myers. I think he's alive and well and living off some accounts that he had squirreled away somewhere in Central Latin America.
All right, Leslie, you were going to make a point about the money, which was important. So it's how much money is gone and how much have they, is there reason to believe he's got half of this $40 million and he's down in Venezuela spending it?
Well, here's the interesting point is that the company he was associated with purchased this Montgomery Bank and Trust Company back in 2010. At that point, he started access to their funds. Now, why internal controls fell apart is yet to be seen, how he got access to this money, moved it over into other brokerage accounts, and then allegedly set up this kind of Ponzi-type scheme. In addition, before that, in 2009, he was collecting from about 115 individuals $40 million in this kind of investment fund. So you add it all up, there's a lot of millions of dollars out there yet unaccounted for. And what was he doing with it? Traveling to Central America, I say he knew what he was going to be doing somewhere down the road and had plans in order to facilitate his lifestyle after his, quote, death.